Is it worth importing a 28-year-old JDM car more than 2,000 miles away? Short answer, yes. Long answer, it is expensive. I'm Alex Clark, and this is the story and hidden cost of how I got my Nissan Silvia S13 from Calgary, Canada to Brooklyn, New York. I'm no stranger to JDM imports. I used to have a 95 Nissan Skyline GTST.
What are those?
Which was technically illegal because it didn't comply with the 25-year rule. Federal law pretty much says that you can't own an imported car unless the car is at least 25 years old, which my Skyline wasn't. Like I said, technically illegal. The bureaucrats got me in the end when I got into an accident and my insurance company totaled the car. RIP. Fast forward 8 years and I moved to New York, which is one of the most unfriendly cities to cars and car owners. But then I got the itch to drive again, which is when I saw this. A 1991 K's Club Silvia Coupe in perfect condition. 60,000 miles, no rust, all original, SR20 DET, red top. Back in its heyday, the K's model Silvia was a beast with triple projector headlights, enhanced sound system, power everything, aero, and hikus. And this one was in minty condition. I had to have it. So I put down a deposit and bought a plane ticket. Split the bill with the company, of course, to check it out myself in Calgary, Canada. After traveling 6 hours, I arrived in Calgary and met up with Sean.
That Jalopnik's like, big deal.
A registered importer at Zen Auto Works. Sean's imported hundreds of vehicles. And on the day I bought the Silvia, this AutoZam AZ1 came in. Back to the mission at hand. And there it was, the Nissan Silvia in all of its glory.
That is super cool.
Oh, it's a beautiful car. It really is. You don't find them like this in Japan. They're usually pretty weathered or they're basically kitted out and turned into a drift car. So finding something that's original like this is pretty special.
First test drive in the Silvia, and it's lovely. It shifts super, super smooth. I could probably teach my girlfriend how to drive this. It's been 5 years since I've driven a right-hand drive car, and it feels just like home.
I'm super excited. This is great.
Past Alex, if you only had an idea what you were getting yourself into. After making sure the car had all of its parts intact.
So this 91 Silvia, I would consider mint condition for the age.
Hey!
Yeah, I think you did pretty good.
Bought the car. But that was just the beginning of the next 6 weeks of paperwork hell. I hired Sean's broker to help get us through customs. Remember the 25-year rule? They verified the car's age and submitted the DOT and EPA exemption forms, meaning it could come over to the States without having to meet those stringent requirements. Then I had to pay to ship the car by train from Calgary to Toronto and then by flatbed to Brooklyn. With the headache of shipping out of the way, I decided to go ahead and get the registration paperwork done. First, to register it, I needed to get auto insurance, which was not so easy because who would have thought most insurance companies weren't cool with the Japanese chassis number being shorter than an American VIN? But I found one that specifically deals in handling classic and foreign cars. Then, I had to find a private garage because the insurance company required one. To top everything off, I get a notice from the insurance company threatening to kick me off the policy if I don't send them a picture of the car inside the garage. I was stressed, to say the least. But what was this? The shipping's been delayed, so now I'm stressing if I'll ever even be able to legally drive the thing. So to get my mind off of one problem, I sought out another one, the DMV. Small trick. If you don't know when your car's going to arrive, make 6 different appointments with 6 different email addresses to cover all the possibilities. And be sure if you're buying from Canada, put down the US price because I got taxed on the Canadian price of $13,500 Canadian dollars, not the estimated $10,000 US dollars. Did you know DMV spelled backwards is FML? Luckily, the car came in 1 day before the insurance canceled my policy.
So he says he has the car and I'm going to pick it up.
All right, this has to be it.
Oh, I see it.
This car is a famous car, everybody.
Yeah.
This car, man.
Yeah. Glad it got here in one piece, it looks like.
I tried my best.
After our short reunion, I send the picture of it in the garage for the insurance, then head to the DMV to get my car adoption papers. Should be easy, right? Nah, nothing can ever be easy. They asked me for 3 missing items to register the car. First, they wanted proof of the customs entry with the original copies of the customs documents. That is impossible to get because they hold on to it at the border. Luckily, my broker sent over an acceptance code from their system. The DMV looked at it and said, good enough. Second, proof of the chassis code on the car itself. It seems everyone has this problem when importing JDM vehicles since chassis codes don't have the same digits as VINs. Instead of getting an etching with a pencil, which the DMV actually suggested, I went with printing out photos. Third, the original title from Canada. It turns out I had the registration, not the title. The DMV folks argued amongst themselves,
"You're crazy, you're crazy, you're crazy,"
and then accepted the Alberta registration and the bill of sale as proof of ownership instead of the original title. After registering it, I had to go and get a state inspection. I get that done, but they put the sticker on the wrong side, and I get a ticket. Fine, whatever, it was done. Like any good owner, I give it a little love. Original Advan wheels, all-season tires, LED headlights, battery. And it was my birthday, so I decided to take a trip upstate New York in the Catskill Mountains.
Going for a ride in the Silvia.
Battery's dead.
No, it's not.
Yeah, it is.
What?
This is my first road trip in the Silvia, and it turns out that car is not going to start.
The alternator was shot. Nobody in this mountain town had any idea what to do with the car. They didn't even know what they were looking at. I called them on the phone and they're like, what's that? So I had to tow it all the way back to the city.
So things didn't quite end up the way we planned.
I ended up going through three alternators before even getting it fixed and had to replace the belt's radiator and fan shroud too because the belt's shredded and it's connected to the water pump and then it was a lot. So 2 months after getting my license plate, the state title finally came in, and I am officially the proud owner of a 1991 Nissan Other with exempt mileage. But of course, the original chassis code is clearly written on the title. So would I import a JDM car all over again, knowing what I went through? Yeah, probably so.